Tennessee Valley. What trailers he got? 460. He'll be in where, L.A.? And Seattle Tuesday morning. I've got a load out of Pasco, Washington, going to Salisbury, North Carolina for him for the 19th. I can load it either the 19th or the 20th. So if he's running late, I can load it on the 20th. If he's on time, we'll load it on the 19th. We load the trucks off the West Coast out of California and Arizona with the exempt commodities, produce, going back to the East Coast into the Midwest. What we do is we secure the loads for them, and out of the revenue of the loads, we charge either 8% or 10% of the revenue for finding them the load. And for doing that, we advance the truck. We give them their money that they need to buy fuel, you know, to make it back to the East Coast.
So if you're just going to stop and look at tires and not
Chino? Bandag? Okay. Okay, babe, I appreciate it. Russell Deaton is loading for Atlanta, Georgia. Call us Monday and we'll load you out of the valley down there. I don't know if he's going to head it east or head it west.
I'll be back here for Christmas.
106 couldn't get by.
La Pennsylvanie, près de New York. Une terre peuplée dès le XVIIIe siècle de solides paysans venus d'Europe du Nord.
About 9 years ago, we bought a truck, and My brother did the driving at the time, and I did the mechanic work, and it just kind of progressed, and we got a few more trucks, and now the trucking is one business, and the farming is another, and we have them all together. I was born just about 9 miles from here, but it was in Lancaster County also, farming country. Well, that was one reason we started trucking some years back, because the farm wasn't paying very well, and trucks were paying good, but now that the fuel prices are so high and everything else is so high, why, nothing seems to make much money. I like to do mechanic work. I just enjoy that.
How many trucks have you got?
Just three.
What's the price of one truck?
Well, a new truck right now is approximately $60,000 for the tractor, and we pull refrigerated trailers. The price of those is approximately $25,000.
Are you going to get more trucks?
I don't think so. I think we'll just keep it about the way it is, because the number we have is about all that I can handle real nice, mechanically and taking care of the bookwork. It's an awful lot of bookwork involved, because we have to keep track of all the miles we travel in each state, the fuel we buy in each state, and at the end of the quarter we have to tell each state just how many miles we travel there, and it's an awful lot of bookwork involved. We've had hired drivers for, I think, about 5-6 years. And right now we have the husband and wife team and then two single drivers. And we get together, you know, work together good with all of them.
One time, during the 8 years I've been driving, I had wanted to buy my own, you know, and to be my own boss and everything, you know, but the way things are going nowadays with your price of fuel and the expenses involved in owning a truck, asking myself, I prefer to work for somebody else, you know, that way I know I have an income every week, you know. I don't know, maybe sometime in the future I might change my mind again, you know, but that's where right now I should have drive for somebody else.
I pay them, but they get a percentage of what the load pays us. In other words, if a load, say a load from here to Wisconsin pays $1,000, the drivers get $250. And then we keep the rest for fuel and maintenance and everything else. It's hard to make a dollar trucking right now.
Good morning. How was your trip this time?
Terrible. A lot of snow out there in North Dakota.
Yeah. We managed to make it home all right.
Good.
We had snow off and on the whole way in.
Where are you heading for?
Hanover.
What do you have loaded then?
Potatoes. Bulk.
How heavy are you?
Too much.
Well.
Yeah, but the weather wasn't real good out there at all.
Truck run all right?
Yeah, not too bad. And a little bit of a problem with the clutch.
With the clutch area. Yeah. More like sticks, you know. I mean, after you drive it for a while, you know, you go to push it in, like, binds up, you know, at first.
Didn't have any trouble with bears out there, did you?
No, but it was cold.
See if I can get you a load lined up Monday to go south where it's a little bit warmer.
Oh, good.
Okay. Now get some, that suits me just fine.
Get a load of fruit for Christmas or something.
Yeah.
How can you get customers? How are you known?
Why, we call brokers. In most big cities, there's a truck broker, and they work between the shipper and the trucker. And the shipper calls them and says, I have a load, say, like going from Lititz to Chicago. Can you get me a truck? We call the broker, and he says, look, I have a load going to Chicago. Do you have a truck available? And that's the way it works out. They publish a book, a fairly thick book, that has the list of the brokers all over the United States and tells what kind of products they haul and arrange loads for and things like that.
How many days a year do you spend in a truck like this, in your truck?
Last year it was about 277 days the entire year.
Which means about 9 months a year.
Yeah, 7 days a week, it'd be about 9 months. The law says that you may not drive more than 5 hours without taking a half an hour break. You're not allowed to drive more than 10 hours without taking at least 8 hours. If you're by yourself, of course, if you run as a team the way we do, it enables you to keep going. I've met quite a few other women drivers out in the road, and I think the woman can do every bit as good a job as the man. This is why more and more companies these days are looking for husband and wife teams or even two women together.
You started to drive with him.
Yeah, and he broke his arm and could not continue to drive by himself. So the man he was working for at the time agreed to let me go along and learn to drive. Do you have a copy? Yeah, I got a copy on you now. Where are you at?
We're about 15 miles west, Capital City here, Big 8.
Hi, Roger. Okay, you're sounding real good down here. Oh, we're going eastbound rather into Capital City.
I ain't going on up at a truck stop, Sue. Where are you headed for? Dropped our load this morning and going up here to a truck stop and have ourselves a bite to eat there and get some motion lotion in this thing, and then we're going to go on down the road to home and get another load back on and probably head down to Keeney State there tomorrow. Aye, okay, Rusty Bucket. Catch you later. Goodbye.
Zach, UCCB is keeping in touch. Keep in touch with the fellow trucker on the road to learn of the dangers ahead or what do you call it, Smokey the Bear, you know, which is just stay please. It takes radar, you know, see how fast you're going, you know. And to help break up the monotonous of running in a truck without nobody to talk to. And to help keep awake, too.
Rockstop. C'est un village ramené aux dimensions de ses commodités, avec un hôtel, des restaurants, de nombreuses boutiques et même un centre météo. Il y en a des centaines à travers les États-Unis, tous semblables. Ouvert 24 heures sur 24. Une seule restriction. On n'y vend pas de boissons alcoolisées, pas même de bière. D'ailleurs, 71% d'entre eux ne boivent jamais d'alcool. Ils se retrouvent là. C'est ici qu'ils vivent quand ils ne sont pas au volant. Ils ne sortent jamais de l'autoroute, sinon pour charger ou livrer la marchandise. Le truck stop est l'oasis de cet univers limité. Pour beaucoup de routiers, c'est la maison, le foyer, car nombreux sont ceux qui n'ont même pas d'appartement. Ils vivent dans leur camion ou au truck stop, 365 jours par an. Fatigue, inquiétude aussi. Il leur faut téléphoner au courtier pour trouver un nouveau chargement, une nouvelle destination. Dans un univers farouchement compétitif, gagner de l'argent est une hantise.
Don't you think the truckers live in a special world, tougher than the other workers?
To a certain extent, yeah, because we put up with a lot. On the road with other traffic and with loaders and shippers and stuff, we have to take a lot.
Yeah.
Compared to what some other people involved in everyday jobs do.
Yeah, you go into a city, you take a chance on being robbed, you know. And for that reason, you have to be willing to be a little tough at times, yeah.
I remember you.
No.
Why not?
Why not? Well, because my employer, you know, he's not doing it. I
saying the biggest reason why we're not members of a union is simply because Snavely Brothers are not. But like you said, we share the profit with the owner instead of being on a salary. And in that way, we're different from the union drivers. The union drivers are paid so much per hour. We're paid so much per load, percentage of the profit of the load.
Why are strikes so tough? Is it because this is such a hard work?
Industry is not so violent in itself, you know. It's the action of the strikers themselves, you know. By throwing rocks off the bridges and shooting at other trucks that are trying to run in the country, you know, this is what makes it so hard.
How much money do you make a month?
Per month, I'd say anywhere between $1,800 to $2,200.
You mean as a couple?
As a couple. Right.
What is the average salary in the States?
Oh, boy. Oh, let me think. 3, 6, 9, 12. Let's see about the golf on this.
Karen, how do you manage to live in such a manly world?
How can a woman like you pass the whole day in a truck?
You learn to cope. You learn to cope with the smallness of space and stuff. How do you make it a home? You do, but you don't. To me, home is wherever we both are. You know, I can make my home temporarily in a motel room when we're somewhere for a few days. You know, I'm much happier that way than I would be if he was gone all the time. We're getting to see more of this country than I'd ever see in a lifetime of vacations. You know, I have a list as long as my arm of places I'd like to go and stay for a few days and visit, you know, cities and areas of the country. I may never get there. I've seen them in passing, you know. Yeah, but we're happy, yeah.
We are interested in accident reductions, and because of the number of accidents that result because of brake violations, we are checking large commercial tractor-trailer combinations, primarily for brake inspections and accident-reducing violations.
Are there a lot of accidents in the American highways?
There aren't a great number of accidents, but those accidents that we do experience, because of the size and the weights of the vehicle, the potential for a greater degree of injury is certainly there. We find that the regulations in California are pretty stringent, pretty tight, and we find that roughly half of the vehicles that we inspect have existing brake violations. Oftentimes, the truck driver is not even aware that he had those violations.
Driver, can you hold it there a minute, please? Hold it there a minute. Set your parking brakes. Set your parking brakes, please.
Le SCALE est un bureau de contrôle des poids lourds, principalement les freins, les pneus, la charge qui est limitée à 40 tonnes. Mais les réglementations sont complexes. Elles peuvent changer selon les États, tout comme est différent le prix des carburants, variable suivant les régions et les compagnies pétrolières. D'un État à l'autre, souvent, il faut remplir des papiers qui donnent lieu longtemps après à des recouvrements de taxes.
7932, what's your 1020?
Vitesse limite, 55 000, c'est-à-dire 82 km à l'heure, impérativement, pour tous, voitures légères et poids lourds, autoroutes et voies normales confondues.
Hello, I'm James.
I'm 1098 from the guard barn. I'll be on 1148, 10-6 for a little while.
Le contrôle est sévère. Radar, voiture, moto et même hélicoptère. Dépasse-t-on cette limitation? Oui, mais en général de peu. 95 km à l'heure est banal. 110, rarement atteint. Pourtant, on compte 4 millions d'accidents de camions par an, pour 23 millions d'accidents de voitures particulières, un rapport de 1 à 6, ce qui est énorme si l'on tient compte du nombre peu élevé de camions en comparaison au nombre de voitures.
Sitting now with the Phantom 570 Club here, KLAC, California Country. Very briefly, we're going to take a look at some truckers' weather now. The forecast for the nation going to be sunny in most places. Continue cold in the northeast. This morning, we have snow falling over the mid-Atlantic states. In southern New England, cold in the northeast, unseasonably mild in the plains and Rockies. And later today, we'll have showers along the northern and central Pacific coast. And along the lower Gulf Coast area of Texas, rain will be scattered over the plateau with snow in the higher elevations now. Had a call just a little ago from Don and Cece. They're out there riding a couple of drivers for North American Van Lines. Heading toward Phoenix this morning, so as they head out to the desert, they want to hear this one. This is Linda Gale. You stand by, Linda Gale. This little song called Waiting at the End of Your Run.
Don't let the loneliness get to you.
To see the world, meet people, and you know, and do a little traveling. So I decided to go out and buy my own truck and start out. I've been in the trucking business for 12 years.
How much did you pay for that truck?
I paid $70,000 for the tractor and $31,000 for the trailer. Just an ordinary tractor. Well, they vary. You can get them for $50,000 on up.
Which means that for the decoration, for everything you put in it, it's $20,000 more.
Yeah, they have them specced out the way you want them.
I'm waiting at the end of your run.
People, they like, you know, to be this. Mechanics like to be mechanics, and I just like trucking. And it's in my blood, so I'm just going to stay with it.
I requested that new song, the one we like so much. I asked him to play it just for you. Be careful with that deep rig.
You never come back home.
I got what I need right here. I got a place to sleep, TV, my music. I don't have no reason to go home. I'm a bachelor. Yeah, I'm just happy as the next person. This is my life, and I just want to do it until I die.
Gone. While they're away from home, maybe we can bring a touch of home through the music or just by talking with them, bring a touch of home with them wherever they might be. That's what we try to do anyway. I answer the phones all night long, and the guys, they will call in, and some of them write letters, but really they're so busy on the road that they don't have time to stop and write. So basically, the communication is when I will go to the truck stops and we'll sit down over a cup of coffee and talk, or the communication is on the phone when I'm on the area. actually, you have to realize that since we just mentioned that they're away from home so much, the truck becomes a second home and in many cases the first home. Man, they're proud of their trucks. They're very proud of that piece of machinery, so they do spend time keeping it clean and making it look good.
The Oberlin Stage Restaurant serves specially prepared wild game, such as buffalo, bear, roast boar, duck, pheasants, and others, in addition to a scrumptious selection of meat and seafood dinners.
Ils sont fiers de leurs machines. Dans l'Ouest principalement, on aime les décorations, les chromes. C'est une marque de noblesse. Des rapins ambulants vont de truck stop en truck stop. Un animal totem vaut 35 $, 140 francs. Un dit-on ironise. Un homme peut avoir une femme ou un camion, jamais les deux. Leur véhicule est puissant, de 4 à 600 chevaux, compliqué à conduire, de 13 à 21 vitesses qu'il faut savoir moduler avec précision. Le défi est permanent. Se trouve différent, distinct, affirmant une personnalité qui se veut marginale. Pour le public, leur profession est considérée comme un des rares métiers virils existant encore aux États-Unis, dans la lignée de l'esprit pionnier, auréole collective et mélancolie américaine. Le costume de cowboy porté par de nombreux routiers se situe donc dans le droit fil de la légende. Le mythe de la conquête de l'Ouest transcende le quotidien. On compare souvent le véhicule à un cheval. Dans le langage populaire, on ne dit pas « conduire », mais « chevaucher un camion ».
I think they have prestige, especially among youngsters, because they are glamorous figures. When you see one of the big rigs on the highway, I think everybody would like to secretly be behind the wheel and driving. I can't drive myself. I know the way I feel about it when I see one of them, I wonder where he's going and how long he will be away from home and how long before he gets back. And I'd kind of... I think that that's the way most people would look at the youngsters. Of course, they look up to them because these are the people who deliver the goods, and these are the people who are what we used to call cowboys. There's no very, very few open ranges now where you can go out and ride horses. And I think it's a good analogy because the cowboy was more or less in charge of his own life. And so that made them a leader in a sense. So the children do look up to them, yes. The will to be free and to do with your life what you want to do.
Well, I pulled out of Pittsburgh, rolling down a decent seaboard. I got my diesel wound up and she's running like I never before. It left the speed zone ahead, but all right. Now I don't see a cop in sight. 6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight. I got 10 forward gears and a Georgia overdrive. I'm taking little white pills and my eyes are open wide. Well, I just passed the Jimmy in a white. I've been a passing everything in sight. 6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight. Well, it seemed like a month since I kissed my baby goodbye. And I could have a lot of women, but I ain't like some of the guys. And I could find one to hold me tight, and I can never make believe it's all right. 6 days on the road, and I'm gonna make it home tonight. 6 days on the road, and I'm gonna make it home tonight. Play the truck driving man. Get out, play.